Welcome back to the fourth quarter of this weekend. Welcome back from lunch. I'm quite happy that so many people are here. I want to give you a short introduction. Why do you need to think about how to finance a free software project? And I want to give you some hints how you might can do it. I will not give you some plan how to get rich or where to ask to get some money. This is really depending on the project you are doing. This is depending on the country you come from. Most likely, most of you come from Czech Republic. I'm from Germany, so I'm not this familiar with some Czech culture things. So where to get money from the government or something. So I want to give you an overview, and I think I'm going to start now. So my talk is pretty much three parts. I want to tell you why I think you need some money in your free software project. I will tell you where you can get money and of course there are issues you have to keep in mind if you deal with money and with free software. And then I guess we are done. If you have any question, I'm open to answer every question, but we only have maybe something like 20 minutes. So maybe we can chat after if it's a longer question. So feel free to ask or meet me later. So a few words about me. Well, I studied kind of business administration, industrial engineering 10 years ago. I'm involved into free software since more than 10 years now, and also involved into Genie about this time. And you have seen me maybe at the booth of Genie in XFC already. And there I'm doing some kind of the finance stuff of our little project. So I got a good overview where the money comes from, where we spend money. But I will not say any numbers here. We can discuss this later. So the first real important thing, if we go to the topic, is why do we need some founding of the project? Well, pretty much everything costs money. And you maybe won't be able to pay it from your own wallet, or you just don't want to pay everything from your own wallet. And that's the reason why you need some finance, some income on your project. If you are not sure why there are costs, well, I give you some examples. The first, and I guess most important, the most important thing is the infrastructure. Well, if you're working with free software, if you're working together with your team, if you're working with your, well, let's say customers and users, and you need some kind of infrastructure where you can work together with them. Infrastructure, well, these are domain names. These are web servers. These are hosting for source code. These are communication channels like maybe ERC or forum, mailing lists. If you're doing some hardware hacking, of course, this means also the hardware you need to hack. So if you're doing some wireless stuff, you most likely need Arduino or a Wi-Fi router, whatever. So these are all things you have to pay, and somebody have to pay it. Maybe I will tell numbers. For Genie, for example, we have costs at about 10 euro each month at this very part of the costs. One really important thing, at least for the mid-sized projects, at some point you will not be able to do any work, or not every work you need to do for a project. So if you are just having a project, maybe 1,000 lines of code, 20 users, this can be done quite easy as kind of a hobby, spare time, whatever. If you're having a project growing, there needs to be somebody who take care about the issues, they need somebody to take care about. Maybe something like email addresses you offer for your project members. Or if you have maybe a huge project like Mozilla is, you will have even people that are responsible for the people involved into the project. So kind of a, well, CFO, CPO, something like this. So pretty much at some point you will need some kind of a back office. And this means you will maybe need some special laptop. You will need some money for hiring somebody who is doing the bureau, the office stuff. For luck, Genie is not at this point, but sometimes I got a feeling we are near. It could be useful. So keep in mind, it's not only about the web server, and it's not only about maybe renting some other server somewhere. There's a little more you keep in mind for the infrastructure. I mentioned the word team. Well, if you start a project, most likely it will be one guy, one girl, inside the cellar doing some hacking stuff. But at latest, if you put the code to GitHub or tell somebody, do a talk, there are more people involved. And more people involved means you create up some kind of a team. And at this point, a team might cause costs beside the infrastructure. You will need to have meetings. Well, this sounds easy. If you are a small project, two people, three people, you can meet up maybe in your kitchen or at a pub or at your local hackerspace, whatever. But if you are a team of 20 people, organizing a meeting becomes time intensive. And of course, it costs money. You have to maybe rent a room. You have to pay for travel, food, beverages, accommodation, all this stuff. And at some point, the team is this big that you might need to organize a conference, maybe not the size we have here, but two rooms, some catering, some stuff. And this is pretty much the same if you need some summit, some hackfest, some sprint to get things done. So be prepared that if your project is growing, you will need money, not only for the servers and maybe not for the back office. You need money for travel costs. You need money for hotels. You need money for rooms. You need money for beverages. This might be not much, and I will show you or I will tell you a way how you can get this money. But keep it in mind. Keep it in mind. And this can be quite expensive at some point. If I remember, the Inkscape Graphics Summit costs about 10,000 euro last year, 2 years ago. So this is really a number at some point. Well, Inkscape is not a mid-sized project in my terms, but just to have a feeling how much this can be. well, I was talking about conferences. Well, if you are doing a cool project, somehow you have to get the people know that you are doing a project. So it's quite similar to the summit. You have to, somehow you have to go, it's not differently. First, of course, you need maybe something like a flyer where you put your major things and also the normal things for your project. So somebody can grab it and take it with you. Not sure whether you have seen CoLab yesterday. They had a lot of nice flyers. This is a good idea. Well, people are asking also for stickers quite often. One of these stickers costs about 1 cent. It's 20 heller, something like this. Not sure in crowns. So if you buy maybe 5,000 stickers, you will pay about 100 euro, which means 2,000, 3,000 crowns maybe. So if you if you want to tell the people that we are doing cool stuff, you will need such things so they can remember your cool stuff. Of course, to tell the people that you are doing cool stuff, you have to go to the people, which means doing booths at conferences like we have here, or doing talks at conferences like we're doing here. Maybe at some point you will need to write an article for a newspaper, or you will just print a poster to put it somewhere, maybe on a bus stop. Well, it really depends on the project you are in. But keep in mind, if you're a small project, and if you're maybe going for fun to such conferences, it's okay. But if you maybe going to five or 10 conferences a year, hotel costs and travel costs, well, we are at this point here, and we're at this point then. You won't be able, or you just don't want to pay all these things, so you have to get money somewhere. Oops. And yeah, of course, the thing nearly everybody misses. If you are doing a free software project, you can't do anything else. I mentioned that with the growing of a project, the efforts needs to be done for the project are growing. Office stuff, maybe reviewing patches, all this stuff that might occur. This means at some point you will get to maybe some point where the free software project isn't a hobby but a full-time job. If you do the project as a full-time job, you will not be able to go to some normal full-time job, and there will be real issue. Somebody have to pay your rent. Somebody have to pay your living. And so I put the cost opportunity costs on it, which means costs you wouldn't have if you don't do this project. Keep this in mind. You have to go to work to earn the money for your living. If you can't do this anymore because your project is getting too big, of course you have to find the money somewhere else. Well, these were the most important cost factors. There might be more. I'm open for any question at this point or any feedback. Well, I guess the thing in most of you are here is where to get the money from. Well, I guess the most important part of this for small and mid-sized projects are donations. On Genie, we have a lot of people sending us €1, €2, $5, something like this. They're using mostly PayPal and Flutter. Some of them ask whether we offer Bitcoin. No. But you shall keep in mind, you will have a huge number of small donations, maybe. There will be a less number of huge donations. I said £500, maybe. It really depends on what you are doing on your project. So one of the projects I know, they regularly got donations about €500, but they're dealing with expensive hardware. So this is another topic. So a regular small software project will not get any big donation, about maybe $500 on a regular base. It's important, now we're back to the cost. Keep in mind that the transactions cost some money, so PayPal is taking a few, Flutter is taking a few, your bank may be taking a fee. So keep in mind, it's not, you have to pay some fees from it. Yeah, the other thing is services around your project. At some point, there's some interest on schoolings, for example. If you're doing a schooling for your project, keep in mind to get certificates. People are laughing certificates. So you can offer schoolings, or you can offer customization, or you can offer some special service. Well, have a look at Red Hat, what they're doing with Linux, and you got a feeling of what's possible at this branch, and you got a feeling how much money you can earn with such services. Of course, this will only work if there is some need for some services around your project. So this will not apply to every project. You can also earn money from merchandising. I told you that that merchandising public relations costs money, but of course it can generate donations. So, well, an example, print t-shirts, put two euros or maybe 20 crowns, 30 crowns on top of it. Sell it to fans of your software or to the fans of your project, and you got a donation of 30 crowns maybe, and you get maybe a happy fan. And you got some extra merchandising because the guy or the girl is wearing your stuff. Of course, you can do this with USB sticks, or you can do it with CD-ROMs, zipper, whatever. Even stickers. So, as you can see, I got the Debian swirl here. This is also working with stickers, kind of. And if you, this is also an important thing, if you grow, you might can organize an event. And on this event, of course, this will cost, but you will can generate some ticket, well, income. I guess I have to hurry a little. One thing, get hired what you are doing. So companies are hiring people which are expert on project they are using. So if your project is used by a company, there's a huge chance that you might get hired by this company. If you are on a famous project, it may be possible that the company is hiring you just because of your references, and then let you work on your project. And of course, take part of things like Google Summer of Code. There might be some program of the Ministry of Education. As I mentioned, I'm not sure how is in Czech working, but there are some actions by public placement. They fund your project and can help you to do the costs. Please don't outsell your project. I know you need money, but never ever sell customer or sell user data. Never ever put too much advertising on your web page. Never ever put some ref links like to Amazon to your web page. This will destroy the good feeling the users will have with your project. This will work maybe for 1 week, this will work maybe for 2 months, but in long term, you will have real issues if this, because you are not free anymore. We can discuss it later. This is a quite important topic, I guess. Well, and of course, you got issues. If you're dealing with money, there's some legal stuff. If you have an income, this might cause fees, this might cause taxes, this might be related to some insurance stuff. So you might have to pay money to the society from this. The easiest way to do this or to have this clean, set up kind of a company or I guess society is the real word. So to get some legal, I'm missing the word. So you got some point, you can everything concentrate on, and it's not on your private private part anymore. So you can really kind of move it away at some point. Friendship. Well, there's this saying, don't give money to friends, and that's true. there have been a few projects, there have been many projects which had issues about their money. They were they split off. They had bad arguments about it. So keep in mind, if you have some income, if you earn money, somebody have to deal with this money. So choose wisely who is going to deal with this money. And yeah, he needs to or she needs to have the real, the correct spirit to do this. And this, I guess this is my last slide here. There have been a discussion, I guess, last year about the development of GNU BG. If you start a free software project and even the project gets quite popular, don't assume that you will do able to that you will earn enough money to do your living. If you want them, if you want to have somebody pay for your project or for service, your knowledge kind of, send them an invoice. Don't do your free software project and begging for donations at some point. This will not work. So, yeah, I guess I was clear. Well, I guess we have still 5 minutes left for some Q&A, if I read my watch correctly. So this was a brief overview, and please go ahead, ask questions. I might have an answer, I might not. You might not have a question.
Oh. Hello. I'd just like to ask about open finances. For example, here in the Czech Republic, we have the idea of a transparent bank account. That's a bank account where you can open up a web page on the bank's website and see all of the transactions that are going mm-hmm. on. And I'd like to know what the risks are involved. Like, when I think about the risks, I think about the idea that somebody could look at my transparent bank account and see that I'm not paying taxes correctly. And so there would be a greater risk that I would be audited than otherwise. Other than that, is there, what should I know about that?
Well, first of all, I guess there's no... Sorry. I guess there's no clear answer. So if you deal with donations, keep in mind that the donators may not be published. So if you have a transparent account, I don't know the concept, so it's just a guess of mine. So if you publish the donators, well, they might be pissed and will not send you any money anymore, or even worse. On the other hand, I guess if you're doing a free software project, there's no big reason why you shouldn't be open with your finance and say, okay, we got this donations, we got these costs. In my opinion, it's completely okay. But, well, it depends on the way you do your free software project. Did I answer your question or did I just...
I would ask you something about money. Can I use crowdfunding for instance Kickstarter for my project?
Sure. There have been many projects be financed by this. Of course, this will only work if you have some kind of a clear plan, some schedule. So you say, okay, I'm planning to implement the firmware for this piece of hardware, or I want to implement a new editor, something like this. So for Kickstarter, you need some good idea of what you're planning to do. And then I've got a good feeling, if the plan is good, there are people which are sending you donations. Well, in the end, they are donations. So a clear yes. I should add this to the slides. This is a good point. There are also some smaller projects like Bounty Source, for example, where you can put some reward onto bugs for free software projects. So people getting involved with this project are getting kind of rewarded if they finally solve a bug. So I've seen IBM just introduced one bounty with about 4,000 euro over there. But to be honest, I never heard the things they wanted to have. So, these are, of course, ways you can finance your involvement into free software, of course. This is good ideas. And just to clarify, it's not working on every project. You need a good plan. You need some back office supporting you on this. But yes.
Is there a government like funding for new projects and also for hiring new like internship or like employers?
Well, I can only say for Germany. Unfortunately, I don't have any clue of Czech at this point. Yes. So, for example, the KNUPG project has been founded by German government a few years. Also, on a regular basis, universities are getting involved with software projects. And, well, there's an example. A couple of German cities went together. They built up some kind of group, and they founded the improvement of LibreOffice in terms of Office OpenXML, the Microsoft file format. So the support on LibreOffice is getting better. So yes, a clear yes. This is what I wanted to say. Look out for Google Summer of Code projects. Look out for projects at your university. At your Ministry of Education, maybe Minister of Traffic, maybe a good point. It depends who is ruling the whole system. But there are projects, and the important thing is find the projects. Get knowledge of who is offering what. So this is maybe ask for doing some social engineering.
On the funding that somebody might get from many possible ways, crowdfunding or government, or this money include also the living cost of the people who work on the project, or people shouldn't touch this money for living cost?
It depends. So if you get money from the state, there are strict rules. What you can do with this money. So, for example, you got maybe 10,000 crowns for travel, you got 15,000 pounds for paper, and 5,000 pounds for beverages, and you are not only allowed to spend this money for these sections. If you're part of Google Summer of Code, of course, you get some money without big restrictions. So it really depends. But keep care, of course. So if you're not playing with the rules, you may be in big danger, financial. Okay. Yep. As the time is up, I will have another talk here now. Maybe you can come join me at our booth, Genie XFCE. This is next to the Red Hat guys, and then we can have another chat, I guess. Thanks for joining.